genre-less. It's a genre in itself, I think. The idea of progressive music is that it should be genre-less. I think in the very true sense of the word, I think we are a progressive band. We take influences from all sorts of music. We don't try to fit into the whole progressive scene. I mean, we've been a band for 25 years this year. You change as a person, you know, your taste in music evolves. You know, we started out being a death metal band, and in the beginning, that's what we were. Yeah, we were finding our feet within that scene, and obviously we were hungry, young, aspiring musicians who wanted to have a career in music and do what we love doing. And I still loved our brand of death metal, if you will. And that's what kept us within that type of genre, I think, because we have that type of vocals. But really, if you would have taken that vocals out of the equation, we wouldn't be a death metal band, really. We'd just be a metal band or a progressive metal band or something like that. But by the time we did the very first record, I had personally moved away from consuming that type of music. I heard what was going on, like I heard our peers, if you will. And I liked some of that stuff too, but for my own influences, I was going back. You know, I was listening to 70s, 60s. And not just rock music, I was going into singer-songwriter stuff, jazz. So I got interested in other forms of music through progressive rock. And with time, 25 years later, I don't really know what we are anymore, which makes us a progressive band. But everybody's got their own, you know, influences, and we go into a writing period, which usually means I sit in a basement, you could say, writing songs or parts, piecing together the songs. I have Fredrik come in, you know, like to lay down some guitar solos and to, I want his opinion, what he thinks, you know. So I put together the record. I sequence the songs in the order I think is good for the record and send out the demos to the guys in the band.
As Mike said, we use it as a kind of carbon copy of the demo, but we, of course, everybody want to put their input, how they play on it, and I think that makes a difference from the demos.
And before I didn't do it, it was just fragments of riffs, you know, a riff on the, like a tape recorder, like with an acoustic guitar, and that kind of became a song eventually. It's a method, basically, I used to get the guys psyched.
It's also good for when Martin is laying down the foundations, the bass and the drums, that they hear the vocal line and stuff like that, so they get the whole idea of the song.
Different feeling.
Mendes lives in Barcelona, so Axe flew down there to rehearse, because the idea for the last two records has been to record the foundations live. So they're playing together with the whole band, so to speak. They're playing together with the demo guitars, demo vocals or keyboards, you know. So they have the whole record when they're playing. They're just adding, you know, we're changing those synthetic instruments from demo into the real stuff, you know. We don't know anything else than the album format. The sequencing is very important to us, in what order we put the songs. I like to think V-shaped records. Start on a high, so to speak, and take it down in the middle and then back up again in the end to create the dynamic within the record. When it comes to single songs or songs released as a single, it's always a record label decision. You know, whenever a single is coming out, we just see it as a promotion vehicle. It's not the best song, it's not the standout song or anything, you know, it's just a taster. And it bothers me a lot if people would listen to the snippets on iTunes. I don't like that song, I don't like that song. That one I like, that's shit, and that's okay, so I'll just get those two songs.
What's up, freaks? Thanks for checking out the first episode of Into the Machine with Opeth. Down below, you'll find a link to buy Opeth's latest album, Pale Communion. And next week on this same channel at the same time, we're gonna bring you another awesome episode of Into the Machine with Between the Buried and Me. So be sure and subscribe, share it with your friends, even your parents are gonna love it. Freaks out.